And today we're going to be taking a look at another LCSW test prep question. Hello and welcome back to my channel, Mental Health with Melissa. If you're new here, please don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button for more content like this. I post videos every single Sunday and Wednesday, as you see here. I get mental health information out there to our communities of color and mental health information to those that are interested in the profession, as well as LCSW test prep. I'm a psychotherapist, LCSW clinical supervisor, and PhD psychology research student. And today we're going to be taking a look at another LCSW test prep question. So today, this is the question that we're going to be focusing on. We're just going to go ahead and get right into it. It is a question on therapeutic interventions. So you are going to need to know different types of therapeutic interventions for the LCSW exam. And if you're not familiar with these videos, I do request that you pause here and then read the question yourself and answer it so that you can compare and contrast our answers. So let's go ahead and break it down. A therapist meets with a client for anxiety and focuses on understanding of early unresolved issues by exploring the client's transference and extensive use of the denial defense mechanism. What therapeutic intervention is the therapist using? Okay, so now that we've done that, let's go ahead and break down the questions. Terminology in the question. So there's a lot of key terms in here. As I always say, the answer is in the question most of the time. So the anxiety is what's being focused on with unresolved issues and exploring the transference and denial defense mechanism. So I'm wondering what these terminologies fall under if we're looking at different types of therapeutic interventions. So option A, dialectical behavioral therapy, also known as DBT. So if you're not familiar, DBT is a type of therapeutic intervention usually used to treat somebody with borderline personality disorder. This therapy model you should be trained in before you just start utilizing it, because again, it's for a very specific diagnosis in the DSM-5. So it uses a lot of mindfulness, and that's how it's applied. Option B, so that's not going to be it, because these don't look like none of the terminologies on here look like they fall under DBT, because this client is not dealing with borderline from what we see. Behavioral therapy. Okay, so if we know about behavioral therapy, we know that it is focused on centering around changes in the behaviors of somebody and really focusing on a therapeutic aspect of how somebody is doing based on what they do. So that doesn't necessarily sound like this. Cognitive therapy is something that surrounds our thought processes and changing our thought processes. Is that something that sounds like what's going on up here? No, not necessarily. Option D, psychodynamic therapy. Now this sounds like it could be it, because if we know about psychodynamic therapy, it is really derived from Freudism, and we know that defense mechanisms, including denial and unresolved issues, really fall under the psychodynamic model. So psychodynamic therapy is going to be your answer. And if you want more test prep questions that center around therapeutic models or therapeutic interventions, then let me know, because I don't believe that there's too many questions on the test like this, and I haven't really gotten any suggestions or requests to do this. So if you are interested though, please let me know. Anyway, that was a short video today. I hope you enjoyed it. Please, again, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. It really helps me get information out there. Until next time, managing mental health matters.